Hey there, my name's Drew Brashler, and in this video, I want to show you how to do an RF coordination with your wireless microphones at your church. Now, if you're brand new to my channel, I'm all about helping you feel more confident with your production gear, no matter where you're starting from. So let's go ahead and dive in. Now, an RF coordination makes it so that your wireless devices play nicely with each other. Now, the same way that an instrument makes octaves. When you pluck a string on a guitar or you press a key on a piano, there's these really beautiful octaves and overtones and everything like that. Well, RF actually works in the same way. There's octaves and overtones. And when you have two wireless devices, they actually interact with each other and they can make little copies of themselves that go across the rest of your frequency band. And so if you happen to accidentally put one of your devices on top of one of these little overtones, or what they're called intermodulation distortion, or IMD, it makes it so that this device actually will end up getting interference or dropouts, or just actually pick up whatever this device is actually doing, which would be bad. And so the difficulty comes in when you have multiple pieces of gear from multiple manufacturers. So if you're just using one device line from a manufacturer, for instance, this Shure SLX-D system, if I had six of these, I could use the programmed frequencies with groups and channels within that family of devices. Now, the difficulty comes in when you add another device, because this frequency of groups and channels was not designed at the same time as this frequency groups and channels. So this is a Sennheiser device, and this is a Shure device. And so if I was to just set these to the same group with a similar channel, that sort of thing, they would be on completely different frequencies, and then these could potentially interfere with each other. And then when you have multiple microphones in one room, that's when you start getting more intermodulation distortion, especially if you have two transmitters and they are right next to each other. That's going to be when you have the most amount of IMD in your room. And so if you have a kids' room right next to your main room and then another kids' room on the other side, and all of them have wireless, you need to make sure that the coordination of the wireless at your church works together. That way you don't get dropouts and you don't get interference on your wireless devices. So there's a couple tools out there, but there is a brand new tool called SoundBase. And this is an online tool that you can go, and I have it pulled up here on my laptop. Go to soundbase.app. And it is a free tool that you can use and coordinate all of the wireless that's at your church or venue. So let's go ahead and check this out. So we have SoundBase, and you can go and read about it. And there is a link down in the description below if you want to check it out. And you can create a free account to do this. I'm just going to go ahead and simply sign in because I already have my login. So here we go. Here is the screen of SoundBase. So you can have multiple projects, you can have multiple campuses, you can have multiple shows all in this view. And so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go ahead and simply click new, and we're going to title this Demo Church. Now, the project location is important because it can pull up the TV channels that are in your local area for your wireless to coordinate too. So I'm going to go ahead and pull up the Avenue Church, which is a church that I used to work at. And that is in Waxahachie. There we go. And so we can pull up a project start or finish date. So for instance, if this was a specific show, then you can mark where your start date is and when your end date is. And for instance, today, I'm just going to pull up that it started today. And then once you have this here, we're going to click coordination, and we are going to press create project. And so this is then going to create the project of your wireless coordination here. And so as we can see, it has pulled up the TV stations in that area coordinated to where that church is. So for instance, this demo church in Waxahachie, Texas, these are the TV channels that are associated in this area. Now, one thing to note about TV channels is that our TV channels get primary function on our wireless frequencies. They are the ones that pay all the money, and they are also the ones that are sending out 1,000 kilowatts or 1,000,000 watts of power on their specific channel. Now, our wireless microphones are in the milliwatts of power. And so you do not want to place a wireless microphone on top of a TV channel because the TV channel is always going to win because it has so much more power and the antennas are designed specifically for extra gain, whereas this little antenna is just here. So we don't want to place a wireless microphone on top of a TV channel. So that's why we have all of these things here. Now, what's really cool is if we go into TV Scout, we can see where these TV channels are, as well as what TV channel it is. And so then if we go over to Scan Recon, this is actually really cool because we can pull up a frequency scan that maybe someone else in the community that's using SoundBase had done recently. And so we can see that I have a tiny SA snapshot in Midlothian on July 24th, and that's pretty close. So I'm going to go ahead and use this. So I'm going to go ahead and press copy to project. Now, this is going to show us how loud these TV stations are in their most recent scan. And so you can, if you have a spectrum analyzer, scan and load this into our project. But in this case, I'm just focusing on the free version and utilizing the least amount of gear for making my RF coordination. Now, the best way of doing things is to have a spectrum analyzer, scan, and then plan your frequencies accordingly to that scan. But this scan was pretty recent, July 24th of 2024. So I would imagine that not too many things have changed since then. Once we've done that, we can go back into our default zone and we can see that we have our scan here. Now, the next thing that we want to do is we want to go and pull up and add every single wireless device that we have at our church. So to do this, on the right-hand side over here, we can go ahead and pull up our device. So for instance, this Shure SLX-D, I'm going to go ahead and pull up. So I'm going to go and select manufacturer, go down to Shure, and then model is SLX-D, and it is a J52. And then at this point, we can do a few things. So we can define if we want our profiles to be really robust, a standard, or just I want to get more frequencies out of my wireless. So at first, let's go ahead and leave this on standard. So I'm going to go ahead and leave that on standard. And once I have this, I'm going to go down here and I'm going to press uncoordinated. And I'm going to type in how many frequencies of this device I have. So I only have one of these. So I'm going to go ahead and add one. And so then we can see that this will add over here on our frequency list. And so I could go in and type this in. So this is a lav mic. Okay, and so let's go ahead and add in my wireless. So I have my Sennheiser, and this is a XSW IEM, and the band is a A band, and we can go down to uncoordinated, and we can type in one. And so we can set that down here. So this is IEM one. And so I actually have another IEM that's here in the studio right here. So I'm going to go ahead and pull that up. It's a Sennheiser IEM 300 G3. There it is. And it is a G band. And we can go in uncoordinated, add one, calculate. So that will add that in here. So I can go IEM 2. And so then if we had some other microphones, we could go ahead and add that. So let me go ahead and add in a Shure, and we can go with the QLXD in the G50 band. And I actually have four of these. So I'm going to go uncoordinated, and I'm going to type in four. going to add them in, and we can go ahead and type this in. So handheld one, handheld two, handheld three, and handheld four. So if I had other rooms at my venue or church, I could go ahead and add in another group. And so for instance, this group, I could go in and group details and call this main room and save that. And then I could go and add in another group and call this kids room. And in this one, we have two of the QLXD4s in the G50 band. And I'm going to go uncoordinated and add two. And that will add that there. This is kids one and kids two. All right, so at this point, I've added all the wireless that is at my church into this. And as we can see, if we go back and look at our manufacturing list, there is a lot of manufacturers that this has by default in this program. And so at this point, what we want to do is we want to go and assign frequencies to all of these devices. And so what we can do is we can see that there are 9 incompatible frequencies, and that's because we haven't done a scan yet. So I'm going to go ahead and press this, and I'm going to click recalculate all incompatible. And at this point, I can go ahead and just press recalculate. At this point, this program is going to be going through and defining all of the frequencies that work with each other. So this is going to be doing thousands and thousands of calculations with these frequencies to make sure that they work well with each other. And so we can see that it gave me frequencies for all of them except my in-ear 2. And so what I can do is I can go and click into this, and I can press recalculate frequency, and we can go and press recalculate and see why. And so that is because this specific device doesn't have a frequency available to us because we have some TV stations up here. So if we go and look, the frequency of 566 happens to be on top of all of these TV stations that are up here in the upper band. And so if I was deciding whether or not I wanted to keep this device or replace it, what we could do is we could then go and see where the open frequencies are. We can see that if we add a wireless device in the lower frequencies, maybe between 470 and maybe 524, then we'd be able to add in a frequency. But in this case, I know that I need to get this specific device to work. And so what I'm going to do is I can go ahead and simply click one of these and open up a TV channel for it to assign a frequency over. And so at this point, I can go and press these little three dots and press recalculate frequency and then press recalculate. And it's going to go and look and see if there's anything, and there is not. And that is because this little red line is called our threshold. And so what I'm going to end up doing is I'm going to go to this right here and up this threshold until we get a little space here for a frequency to go over top of. Now, I would only do this if I absolutely had to do it. So I've done that. And so I'm going to go click this and press recalculate frequency, recalculate. And it's going to offer me a couple different frequencies here. So we can see that there are 4 frequencies that I could select from, and we can see what amplitude our TV station is. So I would want to go and select a spot in this frequency range that has the least amount of volume. And this is in dBm, so the closer that we are to zero or positive, the louder that frequency is. So in this case, I'm going to go ahead and select this 571425, and I can press set. So we can see that I have all of my frequencies here coordinated to wireless frequencies that work with each other. So at this point, I can then go and find all of my devices, and I can assign these frequencies one by one to each of those devices. And once I've done that, I can just go ahead and press the mark as deployed. Because then this gives me a check mark of telling me, yep, I've deployed this frequency. Now, say you are going along and all of a sudden you are getting some what we call RF hits on a wireless microphone, maybe a dropout, maybe a high amount of RF noise, that sort of thing. then what we can do is we can go and just recalculate one frequency. So say I had this handheld 4 and I was getting a lot of interference on it. What I could do is I could either go and select multiple and then go into this and recalculate the selected, or I could simply just press on one of them and go recalculate frequency. And then I could recalculate, and then it is going to define a whole bunch of options for me for recalculating that frequency too. So for instance, I love this 508 300. So let's go ahead and set that. And then once we have that, we can deploy it to that wireless device and it is working. Now, the great thing about this is I can close out of this and then I can go back into this at any point in time. So I can go and press open and open up my coordination, and all of it will load from this RF coordination. Now, there are a ton of more features in SoundBase. And I love that this is a free program that includes so many different manufacturer device profiles within it. And the other great thing is it is on the internet. So as long as you have a wireless connection to the internet, then you can pull up this and do any RF coordination that you need to. It doesn't have to be designated to one computer. So if you're interested in this, go over to soundbase.app, sign up for a free account, and start coordinating your wireless to make it work with each other. Now, I have a couple more videos that are going to be coming out on how to use a spectrum analyzer within SoundBase with the pro version and being able to scan and actually give yourself a coordination that is true to your site, as well as coordinating for a much larger show. So stay tuned for those. But if you do have any questions, or there's a video that you're hoping that I would make on RF coordination or really any of the production equipment that's out there, please post that in the comment section down below, as I'm always reading through those comments to find videos that are going to be helpful for you. If you haven't already, make sure to check out my website at drewbrashler.com. Otherwise, I hope you have a great day.